This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the difference between a traditional income statement and a contribution margin income statement. And more specifically, we're going to focus on the contribution margin income statement as it relates to managerial accounting. First of all, the traditional income statement, what are some of the deficiencies with a traditional income statement? It presents cost information by functional area, but does not provide the cost behavior patterns. This means that it does not show the fixed and variable costs. The primary purpose for a traditional income statement is to provide information for external reporting purposes, that is to comply with GAAP. And that's fine for those that are on the outside using that information, but for internal decision making, it's not the best. It's not the best format. So we're going to talk next about the contribution margin income statement, which provides a much better format for internal reporting. What is a contribution margin income statement? Well, the characteristics are shown here, and I'll go through these characteristics in general, and then we'll take a look at a very specific example on the next slide. First of all, and very importantly, the contribution margin income statement breaks costs out into their variable and fixed components. So it provides that information in the income statement. There are also some subtotals along the way that we'll look at on the next slide. So let me just say this in general, that there is a line item that's called the contribution margin, and that contribution margin is found by taking sales minus variable costs. Then, once we have the contribution margin, we would subtract fixed costs from the contribution margin, and that will give us operating profit. What's nice about the contribution margin income statement is that it provides a clear picture of which costs will change and which costs will stay the same if we change our activity levels. For example, if we change the goods that we produce and sell, we can use the information that appears in the contribution margin income statement to help us determine in the future what those costs will look like. What you see here is a detailed example of a traditional income statement that is the income statement that's prepared for financial reporting purposes, that is, it complies with GAAP, and a contribution margin income statement. That's the bottom part of this slide. It's the exact same company, it's the exact same financial information, exact same reporting period, but the information is presented in two different formats. So if you look, we'll start by looking at operating profit. If you look at the operating profit, it's exactly the same for both of these. So it's really not about a different result in terms of operating profit. It's really much more about how do we present the information. And the contribution margin income statement is the income statement that presents more detailed information and presents how costs behave compared to the traditional income statement, which is much more summarized. For example, you'll notice in the traditional income statement that we have cost of goods sold here of $363,796. But it's not broken out by the part that's variable and the part that's fixed. If you look down below, you'll see that we have cost of goods sold broken out. We have $320,520 of cost of goods sold that are variable costs and $43,276 that are cost of goods sold that are fixed costs. So if you add those two up, though, that will sum or total what you see up above in the traditional income statement of $363,796. The same thing can be said of the selling administrative costs that are listed right here. We break those out in the contribution margin income statement so that you can see the selling and administrative costs that are variable and the selling and administrative costs that are fixed. But if you add those two up, they will sum up to the $164,000 that you see at the top with the traditional income statement. Looking further at the contribution margin income statement, the bottom half of this slide, you'll see that there is a subtotal. It's right here. And it's the contribution margin. And the contribution margin, as we described on the previous slide, the contribution margin is the sales minus our total variable costs. So sales minus variable costs gives us the contribution margin. And then to get to operating profit, we're going to take the contribution margin and subtract our fixed costs. And the contribution margin minus fixed costs gives us the total operating profit. So what this enables us to do, the contribution margin income statement, what it enables us to do, this right here, is to predict in the future what our costs will be, because we know that if, for example, we increase the number of units that we produce and sell, let's say that we go from 6,000 to 7,000 units for the next reporting period, we know that our fixed costs are not going to change, and that in total, and that our variable costs will change. we really can't do that if we use this income statement up here. So the contribution margin income statement really helps us from an internal reporting perspective and decision-making perspective, because we know which costs will change and which costs will not change, and can more accurately then estimate our costs.